chapter one.
Now the first way to lose a man. You've met a charming fellow and you're out for a spin. The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in.
Just leap out, crawl under the car, say it's the gasket, and fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin.
That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game, you sit knee to knee. He says the next man up to bat will bunt, you'll see. Don't say, what's a bunt? This game's too hard for little me.
Just say, bunt, are you nuts? With no outs, two men on base, and a left-handed batter coming up, he'll walk right into a triple play, just like it happened in the fifth game of the World Series in 1923.
That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base.
98 ways to go.
The third way to lose a man. The lifeguard at the beach that all the girlies adore swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh thanks, I would have drowned in just 1 second more.
Just push his head underwater and yell, last one is a rotten egg, and race him back to shore.
That's a swell way to lose a man. You found your perfect mate and it's been love from the start. He whispers, you're the one to whom I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear, let's never, never part.
Just say, I'm afraid you made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making the use of to whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing you a simple chart.
That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just be more well informed than he. You'll never hear, oh promise me. Just show him where his grammar errs and mark your towels hers and hers. Yes, girls, you too can lose.